Hey guys, Corey here. Welcome back to Carpet Muscle TV. Getting ready to start. It's gonna be what, four rooms, two master closets, a hall, and some stairs. And I haven't done one like this in a while. This is one that's in really good shape starting out. So it'll be, it won't involve any of the pre-scrubbing that you've seen me do lately. This one is just basically spray and clean. Let me show you around. It looks, the only carpet in here that looks kind of bad is the stuff that's in the master closets. Because everything's been replaced, but it's got the original in the master closets. That's, if it's a rent house, people usually cut a few corners and they don't replace the carpet in the master closets. I don't blame them, because you never know what somebody that rents your house is gonna do to it. So, you know, and we'll spend too much on it. Let me show you. All right, everything is upstairs here. So here's the stairs. They're not in bad shape. And we've got the master here. There is the original carpet that came with the house. That's very, very common. It's weird, it looks the same everywhere. There's a few, the color varies in some, but you can't walk in one house and out into the next one and have the color be different and have you be able to tell by looking. Only if you put colors side by side. Seems like all the carpet looks the same after a while. All right, that's a hallway area here. And we've got a guest bedroom here. You got a bedroom slash office or something here. It's old school. This house, I would say, was probably built in the early to mid 80s. And we got one bedroom here. So I'm gonna drag all my tools up here, and there won't be a lot to go over on this one. It's basically getting a mild pre-spray and a cleaning. And a groom, and then that's it. On jobs like this, in order to make it, give it that give the carpet kind of that shine, you want to do extra anything you can. Add extra peroxide. There's a ceiling in there somewhere that you shouldn't get peroxide higher than. Difficult to do if you're going to use like volume 20. Volume 20 is 6%. You can clean with it, directly out of the gallon jug and be fine. So as long as you're using clear volume 20, you really can't make any terrible mistakes, unless you decide to heat it with an iron or something. Then you can destroy some carpet if you want to go the trouble to heat it with an iron and use it on red mistakenly or something. All right, I'm gonna drag my tools up here, and I'm probably gonna do the master bedroom first, so I will be back. All right, I'm gonna put out some pre-spray now. Biggest room here. All right, getting ready to come back here and clean this. A couple of people have been commenting, and I haven't answered. So I wanted to cover it in this video, provided they watch this video. Somebody was commenting about a CRB the other day. I don't see the need for a CRB at all with what I do. I was around doing this long before the CRB was invented. So anybody trying to convince me that I need a CRB to do a good job is pissing in the wind. I mean, I don't need it. If I ever get a CRB, it's going to be because I found it used and I got the price. The price was right. And I bought it basically to put it in my collection of carpet equipment that I don't use. I just want to own it. That'd be the only reason why I buy a CRB. I think the same guy commented something about peroxide, about it giving off vapors or something. I'm assuming he was talking about something else and said peroxide instead. Peroxide doesn't give off vapors. It's in toothpaste. It's a mouthwash. It's a gargle. The gargle you buy in the grocery store is 3%. The stuff that I use most often is 6%. You can whiten your teeth with the 6% straight out of the jug. You can slosh it around your mouth and it'll lighten your teeth up. Not poison. Not a noxious chemical. It's oxygen, for Christ's sakes, you know. Actually, if you drink, you can put a couple drops of peroxide into tap water and drink it, and it takes the oxygen and puts extra oxygen into your bloodstream as a free radical. I don't know what that's good for, but that's what a cancer research doctor explained to me one time while cleaning his house and talking about peroxide. Anyway, I just wanted to cover that and go over that. Not a fan of the CRB, big fan of peroxide. Keep in mind when I tell you that I use peroxide, I'm not asking you to use peroxide. That's your business. Use what you want. However, when other guys on the other channels, they tell you don't use peroxide, Corey didn't know what he's talking about, use this instead. Keep in mind how much money I earn when you buy peroxide. Nothing. I'm not affiliated with Sally Beauty Supply, where I buy mine at. So when you go buy, peroxide, I don't see a payment for that. Now the other guys that tell you to go buy this, they do see a profit from that. There's this one large store that routinely recruits carpet guys to sell his product for him. Basically, for a better term, now I won't say it. They're his, itches, so to speak. We won't use the whole word. This is a family show. Anyway, I am a dealer for Challenger. I'm not asking you to buy Challenger, but if you're interested in buying Challenger, I'm more than willing to help you. I'll even send you $100 out of my commission check if you buy it. And then I'm around, via text to help you the rest of the way. Plenty of Challengers have been moving this holiday season. I think I'm selling one right now, in fact. I had a guy texted me. Anyway, pre-sprayed, ready to go. I'm gonna do this in time lapse. That way, I can't stand to watch myself clean carpet slowly. I'd rather watch it in time lapse myself. Anyway, about to begin here. All right, take a quick look around here. This is the master. Got the fan set, drying. We dry really, really quick. Now I clean basically this little section of the hallway here. And you saw me clean this bedroom. All right, so now I'll probably generally leave the stairs out. I might cover them, but I generally usually don't. All right, got that room to do. A little bit more hallway here. And then this room here. All right, I'm gonna pre-spray everything, or one room rather, and knock it out, and we'll take a quick look at it. This is going pretty well. Like I said, this is not a video to learn on. There's really nothing here for me to teach anybody. I guess the thing to take away from this video is that when you have a carpet that doesn't require mad amounts of chemical, don't use mad amounts of chemical. If you're cleaning a carpet that is not heavily soiled and you use massive amounts of cleaner, you're gonna leave residue behind. Now, if you're cleaning a carpet that's dirty as hell and you use massive amount of chemicals, you're taking out the dirt residue, so you're leaving less behind. You know, there's no perfect way to clean and leave zero residue behind. Outside of like distilled water, peroxide, and maybe like a little bit of neutral cleaner and probably alcohol. That would be pretty much residue-less. That doesn't work everywhere, but that would be a good safe mix. All right, I'm gonna pre-spray this guy and I'll get right back to it here in a second. All right, we'll clean a little bit in real time here. All right. This is one of those carpets that you could make really, really good time on if you wanted to hurry. I don't have any interest in hurrying and doing anything but a good job, so I generally don't put any hurry into it, but this would be one that would be a good candidate for it if you wanted to hurry. bit of a mark over there where the bed was at, or where the bed wasn't at, rather. See if I can lighten up here just a little bit more. This is just straight ammonia, is what this is. Huge advocate of ammonia. Ammonia does two things. It is, in my opinion, perfect carpet cleaner. So it cleans carpet and spots really well. And the second thing it does really well is it pisses off those guys trying to sell you expensive chemicals. It does that better than anything. That it just makes those different channels mad as hell at me. I think it's kind of cool, really. From using ammonia as my main cleaner is the pungent smell it gives off. Some people can't handle it. Myself, I kind of like the smell of ammonia. It doesn't, I've used it so long, it doesn't really bother me anymore. I don't notice it. But if it weren't for the pungent smell, I would clean with a mixture of ammonia and peroxide all the time. done with the upstairs. I am gonna go ahead and cover the cleaning of the stairs. I've been using the my blue bonnets today. No pun, the bonnets are blue. Anyway, so what I'm using here, I'm using the blue one on it. It's on the pad driver that Challenger makes. Wonderful bunch of stuff the Challenger guys are making. All right, so we've got all of this already done. Now we're just gonna do the stairs, and then I am done for the day. So I'll go ahead and pre-spray everything, and then I'm gonna do the stairs in time lapse. But I don't know. There's several different ways you can do stairs, VLM. I used to do it with the upholstery tool, and then I finally figured out that it would just be much easier if you use the Oric Orbiter. You can do it all from a standing position. You go down the stairs, you know, and you just, it's really non-labor intensive when you use the Oric for it. Anyway, I'm gonna pre-spray this right quick, and then I'm gonna probably set up the camera down there and clean down that way. Alrighty. Alright guys, thanks for watching. I am gonna go home and upload this video. Tomorrow I've got a really, really big job. I've got to go out of town, drive about an hour and a half, and I've got to, there's like 10 rooms of carpet to clean, and there is like half of a room that needs to be glued back down. It's commercial glue down, so I've never done that, so we're gonna do that tomorrow for the first time. No video on that, but I will video the cleaning. Anyway, thanks for watching guys. God bless. See you tomorrow on another video.